The choice of Katharine Graham seems to me, I mean, she's obviously a fascinating woman, led an amazing life, but the choice of Katharine Graham and the Washington Post company, I wouldn't have expected, you know, to see her, you know, on the list, especially given, you know, when the time you wrote this, you were well aware that the newspaper industry was being eviscerated and the Washington Post, you know, along with it, you know, rescued for $250 million by Jeff Bezos. What was your logic behind including Katharine Graham?
Yeah. She's actually, I think she is maybe the most extreme case in the book of sort of a first-time CEO. So, I mean, the story, how many of you read her autobiography? Has anybody read that? Yeah, so her autobiography is great. I would recommend that. The personal story is just incredible. So her husband is the CEO of the Washington Post Company, which is a private at the time, Fortune 500 sized company. And in, you know, 1963, they're at their weekend home. He goes downstairs and he kills himself in the bathroom, tragically. And so Katharine Graham becomes the CEO of this company. She hasn't held a job in 18 years. There's no training, zero training. And she then sort of spends some time learning about the company, takes the company public. In the 74-75 downturn, an investor, an unknown investor, buys 11% of the shares outstanding. The board is very concerned about this. She goes out and meets with that investor, who turns out to be Warren Buffett, who's completely unknown at the time, and she recognizes that this guy's talented. She puts him on her board. He becomes her sort of, you know, mentor, sensei. So Katharine Graham, the time that company went public in 1971 until she stepped down as chairman in 93, it's a 22-year period of time, has by a mile the best returns, operating numbers, records of any executive in the newspaper industry, and no one else is even close. So this woman who had no work experience, no prior management experience, puts up this phenomenal record. So I think it's a really interesting story. Now the postscript is that she then turns over the Washington Post Company to her son Donald Graham, and he's got to run it across the last 20 years, when the newspaper industry goes from an incredibly profitable, you know, wide moat franchise type business to a technologically challenged business fighting for its survival. And so he's been fighting a pretty significant headwind, but his record relative to the industry, you'd much rather own Washington Post than any other newspaper stock. Nothing else would be close. And that's because they had spent a lot of time prudently diversifying. So most of the cash flow, even when Katharine Graham stepped down, was coming from cable business and the education business and the TV business. They own a big TV station business. So I think it's an interesting story. You got kind of two distinct chapters.
Would you still include her, given, you know, how it ended up with Bezos being?
Yeah, I think the Bezos thing is fascinating, actually.
Well, it is fascinating. I don't know.
I think it's fascinating because that business, I think there's a lot of people thought the Grahams would never sell that business, that it was a family trust. Yep. And the business had been losing money at the operating, you know, income line for years, and that's not going to reverse itself. And they made a, you know, purely rational economic business decision to sell it to Bezos. Who's the perfect buyer for that? It's like John Henry buying the Globe in Boston. I mean, that's where monopoly daily newspapers are going to be like sports teams. They're going to be owned by wealthy local individuals. That's probably the right ownership. And now it's now renamed Graham Holdings. They're purely focused on optimizing those existing remaining business units and then selectively investing that capital. Yeah.
I mean, I didn't check before I came over here, but my gut is that this has not been one of Buffett's best investments were periods when it was looking great, but has not been one of his best.
I think start to finish, it was great. I think over the last 10 years, it's been less than great. And they did a very, you know, complicated but tax-efficient transaction to buy back Buffett's shares in exchange for one of the TV stations.
Right.
So he's now out. But yeah, start to finish, it would be, I mean, I don't know, he was in it, so he's 40 years, it's probably a high teens, low 20s IRR for him.
So almost as good as See's Candies.
Almost as good as See's Candies.